Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1752. Convert dates to a months and years table. All right, today's question sent in by James. James has 10 years worth of check data, date and amount, and he wants to build a table with years going down and months going across, and would prefer not to have to add new columns with equal year. And then I wouldn't use equal month, because month just gives us a month number. I would probably use equal text of this, comma, MMM for the month abbreviation, or 4Ms for the month name, either way. All right, so we'll select our data, insert, pivot table. And today I'm just going to create the pivot table on an existing worksheet right there, click OK. And initially we're going to put dates down the left-hand side and check mark amounts, and so we end up with almost the original data that we have there, but we're going to use a great feature in pivot tables. Now you need to go to the first date field, or first date cell, so right there in D5, and then on the pivot table tools options, if you're in Excel 2010 or earlier, or it's called Analyze in Excel 2013, it's the first pivot table tools tab. Now we're going to choose group field and choose both months and years. Click OK. And what that does for us, that gives us a brand new field that we didn't have before. It's a virtual field called years, and the old date field is now really months. All right, so we'll take the years field and pivot it to go, you wanted years to go down the side. We'll take the date field and pivot it to go across the column labels. And we now have Jan, Feb, Mar. Column labels and row labels, let's get rid of those. That's design, report layout, show in tabular form. Now we have normal columns there, and our data for August through December is not filled in yet because we don't have that data. If you wanted those to be filled in with zeros, easy enough, come here to the options and say for empty cells, show zero, click OK. But you know what, this is one case where I think I actually want to leave those as blank because we just don't have the data yet. All right, well, hey, I want to thank James for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast, Mr. Excel.